best gift to the humankind, as they do the job of 20 for free. Mother's well-being is the call of the hour. This is where Million Moms comes. It is an initiative to empower a mom, to prepare her for the future, to instill the confidence to look up at the world and say, I am ready to take in more. Million Moms is the brainchild of Dr. Mani Pavitra, a social entrepreneur and founder of Million Moms. Our three signature programs, the 21-day challenge. We bring you simple and fun tasks that transform the mind, body and soul to be taken up for 21 days and then share your experiences online to inspire more mothers to take it up too. Mom's Health Splash. This is a combination of food and fun events also featuring voga, water yoga. The idea behind the event is to bring in a behavioral change in the entire family about the health and fitness needs of the mother. Mom's Day Out. We organize yoga sessions, dance, aerobics, innovative health and fitness-based games in an exclusive community space. What would a 21-day challenge do to moms? Lowering stress levels, helping in creative and innovative thinking, an extremely fit mind, body and soul. Let us take up the 21-day challenge for the health and fitness needs of the mother.
Take up the 21 days challenge. Log into www.millionmoms.in. For more details, contact 77024-9111.
I'm loving this initiative called Million Moms. I know for a fact that mothers do not take care of their own health or their well-being. They always prioritize their children, their spouse, their parents and in-laws. But I think being a healthy mom will create a healthy family. And if a healthy mom actually brings in fitness into her lifestyle, she can become a role model to her entire family. So I really support this initiative, and I'm happy that we have this wonderful team of people who are actually doing this initiative, and I'm all for this 21-day challenge.
Dr. Pavitra has initiated this Million Moms, and it's so wonderful, because we women struggle so much, not just at home, but at workplace, and compete with every other man out there. And physical and mental wellness is definitely required for us to be able to do well. And I also am a mom, and my kid is 14 year old, she's in 10th, and my son is in first standard. And then, basically I know how it feels to be able to, take care of your kids and work really hard outside. So your mental wellness and physical fitness is definitely essential. I think this Million Moms initiation is definitely helpful for us, and I've seen the panelists coming here and they're extremely good, and I realize that, fitness is very much required in these days. And yeah, I think I have already taken up the challenge. I started working out. I hope to see a good transformation maybe in 21 days from now, to shed some weight and come back again and say, you know what, I rocked.
I am so happy that this initiative has come up, Million Moms. Not everybody steps out of their house once they become a mother, and they do not pursue their dreams. So this is a wonderful platform to all the mothers out there, and thanks to Pavitra and team for bringing this up for a lot of mothers like us. Though I'm into fitness, it really takes a lot of effort to pull in other mothers to get into a physical and fitness activities. So I wish all the best to the entire team, and I look forward to be a part of a lot of such initiatives in the future.
I just love this initiative. The Million Moms is fantastic. I think my contribution is to inspire people that they should be fit, take care of your health, take care of yourself. That's what is important.
I'm really very happy to be associated with the Million Moms. It's a wonderful initiative, and I would like to encourage my own women who are working with me and the families of my policemen to go through this.
Initial stage of this Million Moms. Once I started, I made sure that from my relatives, I started adding them as members. And we cannot force people, but we can let them know you can do it. So that is how I started to share. So few of them, they are in a like dynamo, okay, whether we can do or not. So I just keep telling them, don't think that you cannot do anything. You can do it. Might be it's like it's not an hour or so. You can do at least 10 to 15 minutes in a day. And it's not only a physical and a strong exercise that you can do, but it can be at least a kind of meditation which can help your health.
It's a wonderful thing to improve the health of women, because women do neglect their health across all walks of life, which as an oncologist, which I see, is every woman, they take family, everything has a priority than their own health. That's why even 60% of women's cancers, they come in late stages and losing their lives, which is a lot only loss to the family, loss to the society also, because woman is a mother, sister, daughter, for many people. So this is a wonderful concept where they can at least come to such yoga and all. The fitness, everything will improve and they keep themselves healthy.
మదర్స్ గురించి ఇలా అవేర్నెస్ తేవడం అంటే చాలా మంచిది. ఈ రోజులో జనరల్ ఎవరు పట్టించుకోరు. ఈ కమర్షియల్ లైఫ్లో ఏంటంటే పెద్ద ప్రయారిటీ ఎవరు, బట్ మదర్స్కి ఇవ్వాలి. ఎందుకంటే వాళ్ళు ఇచ్చిన లైఫ్ వల్ల మనం ఇలా ఎంజాయ్ చేస్తున్నాం ఈ ప్రతిరోజు ఎవ్రీడే. సో మనం ఎంత బాగా ఎంజాయ్ చేస్తున్నాం అంటే బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ ఉంది. సో అది మనం మర్చిపోతున్నాం ఈ డైలీ లైఫ్లో. మంచి ప్రోగ్రామ్ మీరు అరేంజ్ చేసి అందరికీ మంచి అవేర్నెస్ తెచ్చారు.
నాకు మా అమ్మకి ఉన్న రిలేషన్ గురించి చెప్పాలి అంటే అది ఎంత చెప్పినా తక్కువే. ఎందుకంటే బుక్స్ రాయొచ్చు, బికాజ్ నాకనే కాదు, ఐ మీన్ ఎవరికైనా సరే. సో ఆ మదర్ ఇవాళ మనం ఇవాళ ఒక ఈ స్టేజ్లో ఉన్నామంటే బికాజ్ ఆఫ్ మనంత హార్డ్ వర్క్ చేసినా, మన ఎంత ఇచ్చేసినా వాళ్ళ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ వాళ్ళ సపోర్ట్ ఉంది కాబట్టి వాళ్ళు ఈ స్టేజ్లో ఉన్నాం. అండ్ బికాజ్ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ మా అమ్మగారు చాలా మంచి ఆవిడ అండ్ అట్ ద సేమ్ చాలా అమాయకురాలు. ఎప్పుడు కూడా లైక్ నువ్వు తప్పకుండా గెలుస్తావు, నాకు తెలుసు నువ్వు తప్పకుండా సాధిస్తావు అంటే ఆల్వేస్ పాజిటివ్ మాట. సో ఆ పాజిటివ్, ఆ విల్ పవర్ నాకు చిన్నప్పటి నుంచి బాగా అలవాటు, ఎస్ ఐ కెన్ డూ అని చెప్పి. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్, అదే నన్ను ఇండియన్లు గెలిచేలా చేసింది.
ఫ్రీజ్గా ఉన్న లేడీస్ రాత్రిపూట సరిగ్గా నిద్రపట్టదు, గొరకు వస్తుంది, బ్యాక్ పెయిన్ వస్తుంది, నీ పెయిన్స్ వస్తాయి, త్వరగానే ఆస్టియోఆర్థరైటిస్ వస్తుంది. అయితే మదర్స్ పిల్లలకి ఎంతో జాగ్రత్త తీసుకుని వాళ్ళ మీద వాళ్ళే జాగ్రత్త తీసుకోకుండా వాళ్ళని వాళ్ళు అశ్రద్ధ చేసుకోవడంతో వచ్చిన ఒబేసిటీతో పడే బాధలు ఎన్నో.
ఇల్లుని చూసి ఇల్లాలని చూడు అని అన్నారు, అలాగే ఇల్లాలను చూసి ఇల్లుని చూడు అని అన్నారు అని ఎట్లా అనేవారు ఇదివరకు గత రోజుల్లో. ఇప్పుడు కూడా అట్లాగే మన ఫాస్ట్ మూవింగ్ వరల్డ్లో ఇంట్లో ఇల్లాలు ఎంత ఫిట్గా ఉంటే ఇల్లు అంత చక్కగా తీర్చిదిద్దుకోవడం జరుగుతుంది అనేది మనం తరచూ గమనిస్తూనే ఉన్నాం. ఈ మదర్స్ ఈ రోజుల్లో కిడ్స్కి ఉన్న రిక్వైర్మెంట్స్కి కానీ, లేకపోతే హస్బెండ్కి ఉన్న రిక్వైర్మెంట్స్తో కానీ, లేకపోతే తనకున్న వర్కింగ్ మామ్ అనే కమిట్మెంట్ ఉండటం వలన కానీ, వాళ్ళ హెల్త్ను వాళ్ళు డిస్రిగార్డ్ చేసుకోవడం, పట్టించుకోకుండా పోవడం, దాంతో ఈ లేనిపోయిన అనారోగ్యాలన్నీ రావడం అనేది జరుగుతుంది తరచూ మనం చూస్తూనే ఉంటాం.
ఈ బాధలన్నిటి నుంచి విముక్తి కలిగేది ఎట్లాగా అంటే ఫిట్నెస్తో. మంచి మంచి ఎక్సర్సైజెస్ ఉన్నాయి. ఇవాళ రేపు ఫంక్షనల్ ట్రైనింగ్ అని, క్రాస్ఫిట్ ట్రైనింగ్ అని, ఇలాంటి ఎక్సర్సైజెస్ దగ్గరలో ఉన్న జిమ్తో మంచి పర్సనల్ ట్రైనర్ పెట్టుకుని వాళ్ళకి అవకాశం ఉన్న టైంలో వాళ్ళు చేసుకునే ప్రక్రియలో వాళ్ళు ధ్యాస పెట్టాలన్నమాట.
ఇంట్లో తల్లిని లేకపోతే ఇల్లాలని మనం ఫిట్నెస్కి మనం ప్రోత్సహించడం అనేది చాలా ముఖ్యమైన విషయం. దానివల్ల మన సంఘం మెరుగుపడుతుంది, దానివల్ల మన ఫ్యామిలీ అనేది మెరుగుపడుతుంది, దానివల్ల ఫ్యూచర్ జనరేషన్స్ కూడా మనం క్లియర్ డిఫరెన్స్తో మనం ఎంత ఇంప్రూవ్మెంట్ అనేది మనం క్లియర్గా చూస్తాము.
అయితే లేడీస్ ఫిట్గా ఉన్న లేడీస్కి ఫ్యామిలీ అంతా ఫిట్గా ఉంటుంది. మదర్ ఫిట్గా ఉంటే పిల్లల్ని ఛాలెంజ్ చేయగలదు ఆడది, మదర్ ఫిట్గా ఉంటే వాళ్ళ హస్బెండ్ కూడా ఎంకరేజ్ చేయగలదు. మదర్ ఫిట్నెస్ బట్టి వాళ్ళ ఇంట్లో తయారయ్యే వంటకాలు అవన్నీ కూడా ఫిట్గా ఫిట్నెస్ ఫ్రీక్స్కి తినే పదార్థాలు ఇంట్లో అవటం జరుగుతుంది. సో ఫిట్ మదర్సే ఈ ఫిట్ ప్రపంచానికి దారితీస్తుంది అన్నమాట. సో లేడీస్ ఫిట్నెస్ మీద ఎక్కువ ఫోకస్ చేయడం చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్.
సో మనందరం ఒక తల్లికి ఒక ఇల్లాలికి తన ఆరోగ్యం మెరుగుపరుచుకోవడానికి డైలీ రొటీన్ నీట్గా జరిగిపోవడానికి మనం వీలైనంత తోడ్పడుతూ వాళ్ళతో పాటు ఫిట్నెస్లో మనం పాల్గొంటూ వాళ్ళని ఎంకరేజ్ చేస్తూ చక్కటి జీవితం అనేది మనం తయారు చేసుకోవడం చాలా ముఖ్యమైన విషయం.
After independence, Mr. Sarib Rasul Khan has been extremely supportive to the cause of the fitness of mothers and women and has been very supportive to the Million Moms initiative. Also, lot of staff at this Shadan Medical Institutions have been instrumental in making this event a possibility. We extend our heartfelt gratitude to Sarib Rasul Khan, the Managing Director of Shadan Institute of Medical Sciences, and the entire team of Shadan. Also, we'd like to extend our gratitude to Adlands, Precious Escapes, Sante Spa, Manisha Kapoor, and also our gift voucher sponsors, Saloni Jain, VR Fire Safety Solutions, Half Sugar, Crunchy Nuts, Plan a Plant, and Gold's Gym. Now I'd like to hand over to Prema Malini to take the program further.
Yes, only one hand. Oh, that's great. Okay. Thank you so much for participating and making it this big and successful. Really, really thank you so much. Moms, you can do anything. You can do anything, yes. And the men behind these moms, I appreciate all of you guys. Really, really please raise all your hands and give a big hand to all the men who motivated all these moms. Okay. I know you must be all very hungry and you must be in a very hurry to go back, get back home. Today is a Sunday, I can understand, but still, these memories and these moments are also very precious, right? What do you say? So, just a few more minutes and then we can all push off. But just 10-15 minutes more. In the meantime, you'll be having your lunch, so we will wrap it up. Okay, before we go to the next thing, I just wanted to appreciate Alka Agarwal. Can I have her please on the dais? Alka Agarwal? Can I have Alka Agarwal please? Yes. Alka Agarwal is not just a mom who came here to participate. She motivated around 15 moms. Very big hand to Alka Agarwal.
Thank you so much. Thank you. And all thanks to Mani Pavitra and her team, because she is a motivating mom herself. A motivation always pulls a motivation.
Thank you so much, Alka. That means a lot. And we have something very interesting here. Tanya, Priyanka, and Deepa. Who are they? Where are they? Tanya, Priyanka, and Deepa. Please come over to the dais. Please come. So, you know why I'm calling them? Any guesses, please? Why am I calling them? Yes? Please, you should be quick in guessing. What's the reason? Why am I calling them? Yes, best dressed as well as best groupie and then a good social message. So this car number 43, right? So how was the experience?
Very good. Yeah? It was very good, very different. First time of, for me, a car rally like this. Yeah.
We really had a good time. Thank you, Pavitra, and your entire team.
Yeah, we really had a good time. Thank you so much.
Okay, you please hold on for 2 minutes. We request the BJP spokesperson, Ms. Kolli Madhavi Garu, to please come onto the dais to hand over gifts to the great selfie group here. The well-dressed group, you're going to receive an award. Kolli Madhavi Garu, I request you to please come onto the dais. Please give a big hand.
Hi, everyone. It's our first TSD drive, and we are so happy that it's, you know, based on our very unique thing. You know, we are all moms here. So based on that, we did something new today. We totally enjoyed the experience, and it was great fun being a part of this. Thank you so much. To all the organizers, it was a very well-organized event too. I'm sure you'll all agree with us. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.
So here are the gift vouchers from Saloni Jain.
Thank you, ma'am.
You spoke? Hi, everyone. We wanted to bring out this message that how the sun is the center of the world, how all planets revolve around the sun. Our mother is the center of our world. From her, we derive all the energy, all the inspiration, all the love, everything. But in the process of giving it to her kids and her family, she sometimes neglects herself. So we are just trying to remind mom that you are our shining sun. So please do not forget that. Only when you are happy, you are healthy, and you are fit and fine, we all are happy and healthy. So. Thank you so much.
Okay, 1 minute. You need to now say the same lines and motivate others. Okay, those lines. Let them repeat. 4 lines.
Of course. They'll all repeat. Yes. Okay. It's run for hell.
No, don't say run for hell.
Run for hell. Run for hell. You guys have to repeat after us.
As loud as possible.
Yeah. Run for hell.
Run for fun.
Run for fun. Mom, you're the one.
Mom, you are the one.
Our dear shining sun.
Move. Yeah. Our next award winner, Mr. Vikram Chandra, for the well-dressed car. I request Mr. Vikram Chandra to please come out to the dais. The gift sponsored by VR Fire Safety.
Vikram Chandra.
I'm sorry for pronouncing it wrong. Vikram Chandra. Yeah. Can I have you on the dais, please? Okay, friends, I've been a journalist since more than 15 years. Ma'am, I just want to ask you one thing. You've been a mother, you've been taking care of your home, also you've been a busy politician. And how do you take time, you know, whether it is 10 minutes or half an hour or 1 hour, how do you take time to maintain your fitness?
To be very honest, I actually never concentrated on my health. Till very recently, I mean, till the past 1 year. It is very recently that I felt that even I too have to take care of my health, because we all, especially when you see the world ranking, we say that India is standing fourth in being lazy, especially women being lazy. I don't agree that women are lazy in India. Instead, I say women care more for their family and children rather than being lazy. It is that women don't care for themselves, They give time for their family and children, but we don't give time for ourselves. So I don't agree that we Indian women are lazy. In fact, I say we are the best caretakers in the world. We are the ones who give more time for the family and relatives, friends, whatever you say, you name it, we are there. But we don't give time for ourselves. That is the only drawback we have. Now, I being in politics, I mean, to be very honest, what you see me today is different what you would have seen me 2 or 3 years ago. I was very, very fat to what I am now. I am fat even now, but still I consider myself I'm much better and fit now to what I was earlier to 2 to 3 years ago. When somebody used to tell me you're fat, I used to get angry. I used to say, who are you to comment on me? When I am the one who's bearing my weight, why are you bothered about it? But later, when I realized my health is important for me as well as the family. If I'm healthy, I can take care of my family. And now after being into politics, I can take care of the society also. So this made me, the thought that if I'm healthy can serve, can help me serve my family as well as the society, made me take some time. And now I start working out, I go for a walking. And at home, I'm on the treadmill, I'm on the cycle. I give time for myself now, I take care of my health. And I'm much fit now. I lost almost more than 20 kilos in the past 1 year.
Amazing. I think you all should give a big hand of applause. And so, how much ever busy you are in your life, in a day-to-day life, please take out at least 15, 20 minutes. I'm taking out, even I'm also like that, what Kulli Mathai was saying. I was also overweight. Now also I am overweight, but better than before. So thank you so much for that wonderful thought. Now I request the doctors here, all the four of us, because when you speak something, whatever you say, people consider that that is a truth and you need to abide by it and you need to go by it. And now this is the time and place where you need to speak your heart out about why it is important for a mom to be fit. I first request Dr. Dashrath Ram Reddy Garu, who is an orthopedician. Doctor, I know, see, people come to you once their bones break. Once they actually come only for surgeries or some kind of clinical, what's happened to their body and all. But I want to ask you, before breaking bones, how do you see that the bones don't break? So my question to the doctor is, as an orthopedician, what do you suggest to the mothers? Why should they move? Why should they be fit?
Okay, good evening everybody. Good evening, everybody. Thanks for the opportunity. Thank you for inviting me as a panel discussion. I always say, as Madam Madhavi said, the mother, the women, is the backbone of the Indian society. Unless she is fit, the family will not run and the society will not do well. Henceforth, the country will not do well. Whenever the patient come, I discuss about their problem 5 minutes and I discuss about their nature of lifestyle another 10 minutes. Many a time, 2-3 people were little restless when I was talking about their lifestyle. But I said that I have no interest in knowing your personal life, but being a doctor, I am not here to make money. I want all of you to be happy. My motto is smile on your face with a healthy life. A patient comes, so usually a person who is 45, 50 years old people, especially women, they come to me. Usually they are accompanied by their children or husband or family members. I first discuss about the problem, what that lady is having. I investigate, I advise what to do. Then I switch over asking the accompany what is the relation between the lady who has come for the treatment, and I look at the person, whether it is male or female. I look at their what do you call that, body weight and all, how they sit, how they walk. I tell them very clearly, please don't mistake me telling this. Within no time, you will fall the way your mother or aunt has come for me the way. If you follow my advice, you will not land in the problem what she is having right now. If she is obese, not every obese patient is because of the overeating. One is because the genetic predisposition or a lack of exercises or lack of knowledge. I always say, whatever may be the reason, the weight is going to produce some problems like osteoarthritis, mechanical backache. Once their activity has come down and other works or occupations at home, they will not get exposed to the sunlight. That's most of our Indian population, irrespective of the sex, whether it is a men or women, they have a vitamin D deficiency. And some people who work in the field from morning 6 to evening 6, still they lack vitamin D deficiency. The reason, because we, most of us from South India, our skin is little dark because the melanin content is more. Because the people who are having a more melanin in the body, they will not have a vitamin absorption. Henceforth, they will not have a calcium resorption. That's how they develop osteoporosis. The second reason is, as madam said, women first take care of their children and their husband and their in-laws, their parents. They never care for their diet, balanced diet. They see whether these people are having the food or not, and they will eat whatever that is left over. Sorry to use the word, sorry. Most of us are middle class or below middle class families, so I'm telling you that. The leftovers they eat or they sacrifice. Okay, my son has had it, my daughter had it, my husband had it, my in-laws had it. Enough, I can have a cup of, a glass of buttermilk, or I can have one sambar rice, something like that. They close the meal and they take rest. Sometimes they skip the meal because they're so tired, they can't take the meal. That problem starts from there. Eating will not produce obesity. If you don't eat properly, it produces the obesity. That is the secret. People say, if somebody is obese, hey, are you eating too much? No. Because you are not eating proper meal, you are not eating a meal in a regular intervals, people are putting on weight. That's the irregular habits, food habits. So what I always say, have a proper sleep, sleep on a proper bed, take brisk walk at least 20 minutes minimum in the morning, 20 minutes in the evening. As an orthopedic surgeon, Madam said that she does treadmill and all, but with due respect to madam, please don't do treadmill. The treadmill is invented to the places where there was a lot of ice on the roads, like European countries or eastern part of America or Scandinavian countries. You don't see the sunlight. So they sit at home, they have to do some exercises. So that was invented for them. These multinational companies started dumping those walking, these treadmill machines to us. We are crazy buying them and using them. We should not do treadmill. Even it is, if you are compelled to do that, please do with 4.5 kilometer speed on a slant. People keep it in a upright this position, upwards, and like a mountain climbing, they do that. That is going to knock down your knee joints very fast. And jogging, Zumba, aerobics. You may be fit by Zumba, aerobics, and all skipping. That will knock down your knee joints. I always say, you can do a cross trainer, swimming, partial squats, brisk walk. Only four things. Cycling. In my opinion, cycling and swimming is the best exercise for any human being.
Note, I would like to say something. Dr. Mani Pavitra has always been promoting these 5 points, and since Million Moms has started and the 21-day challenge has started, we've been promoting squats, walking, swimming, cycling, and cross training.
Very good.
Thank you so much, doctor. Thanks a lot for your insight.
Thank you
and
very much.
And now I request Dr. Lakshmi, the endocrinologist and the diabetologist. Ma'am, you are the most important person for all the mothers over here, because most of the mothers, once they bear children, their focus completely shifts to children, household works, career, husband, etc., etc. Very few people focus on their personal health and fitness. And they end up having thyroid, blood pressure, diabetes, knee pains, joint pains, backaches, blah, blah, blah. I'm sure the patients who come to you, at least 90% of them, the mothers I'm talking, are not going through any kind of fitness regime. I want you to throw light on this and want to ask you, how do you maintain your fitness and what do you advise your patients?
Thank you for, first of all, Prema and the PQ, Pradeep Garu and Dr. Pavitra and all of you. Every one of you has made it very special today by being here. Thank you for coming. The thing is, I'm an endocrinologist, which means I'm a specialist of diabetes, hormonal diseases and obesity, which I deal with metabolism, endocrine disorders and diabetes. So I deal with these diseases after the disease happens. So people come to me with diabetes, with thyroid disease, with PCOD, with obesity, with childhood obesity, with infertility, with irregular menses, with hair growing on their face, pimples on their face, and hair loss on their scalp. They have the stretch marks and they have the knee pains, joint pains, osteoporosis, osteoarthritis, and a lot of complications with obesity. The patients I see mostly are women, because all these hormonal diseases are affected 8 times more than men in women. So it is a very sad story. Once they come to my office, they pay the fees and they're in front of me in my clinic. It's a sad story because they've gone through a whole lot of hardship and they came to me with the end result of a disease. I wish I could be like Dr. Pavitra, who would be preventing the disease. She's taking this challenge, the 21-day challenge, the event, the program, the education, the preventive measures, so they would never end up in my clinic. So my business should be zero if her business goes 100%. So basically what I want to say is, if you do your job properly, you will never see me in your life. I don't want you all to ever have a polycystic ovarian disease, you or your daughters, you or your, you know, daughter-in-laws, your granddaughters should never have this disease. And this disease happens in a little girl who became obese, whose parents were diabetic, whose grandparents were diabetic. So it's a gene inherited by the family, and these girls have become obese due to lack of exercise and excessive eating, excessive calorie intake, which the parents could not even supervise and prevent it. So it's a big problem. And to be honest with you, I come from a family where we eat lunch and dinner just like how we had a very grand food, you know, a very grand dining table. My father was an army officer. He is an ex-NDA. My mom was a beautiful, very, very, very wonderful cook, chef, a great mother, a dedicated mother. So all we did was eating all day long. So we had a very good breakfast, lunch, dinner. So obesity was in the family. So we became obese, overweight, right from the young age. We were very fit also. My father being an army officer, he made sure we were very fit. So we had fit skeleton, fit muscular strength. But we were obese because our calorie intake was much higher. So every time I gave birth, I went to 100 kgs. Both the boys were born 100 kgs. It was very hard for me to lose that weight through dieting, through exercise. Every time with my busy schedule to lose the weight, because the more and more I studied my medicine, the 35 years of my life went in studying medicine and endocrinology. The more and more I studied, I found out that it is all about lifestyle that these diseases come to the people. So it is basically your lifestyle, how you sleep, how you wake up, how you eat, how much you eat, what do you eat, how much you exercise, and how do you deal with your exercise routine, how do you incorporate exercise in your day-to-day busy life. So I've seen a housewife sitting and watching TV all day. I've seen a housewife running after the children all day. I've seen a very busy working woman all day. I've seen a woman who is traveling all day. I've seen a man doing every kind of all household work and office work, everything together. Basically, it depends on how you balance your life. See, don't you agree that if I start my clinic at 7 a.m. in the morning, I will have a whole lot of patients to see? I will have patients from 7 a.m. to 12 in the midnight.
the longer I stay in my clinic, the more patients I have. Because it's a business, it's a lot of people have these diseases and they want my help. So I can work like a dog, make money like a millionaire, and what will I do with the money? I cannot even buy a fit body anywhere. Nike store only sells shoes, it doesn't sell fit body. So you cannot buy fitness and health in any store. You have to buy it yourself. How would you buy? Rather than starting a clinic at 7 a.m., start at 10 a.m. So you can make time for gym or whatever fitness, 1 hour of fitness you need to do. So dedicate 1 hour for yourself, then dedicate another hour to get ready, have a good breakfast, serve your husband, serve your children, do your puja, whatever you have to do, your personal time. So 1 hour of fitness time, 1 hour of personal time is the secret for a fit and a happy body. Because by the time you're 40 or 50 or 60, what would you crave for? You would crave for health, you would crave for fitness, you would crave for good looks. You have a lot of diamond jewelry, beautiful clothes, lot of saris, good cars, good house, good money for vacations. If you don't have good health, all you are doomed. You are completely doomed.
With that, I'll end. Thank you so much, Dr. Lakshmi. It was so inspiring and motivating. And I'm sure your boys, because today morning you were telling me something, that your boys were like shocked when they saw you in this attire today, that you're going to this rally. So what did they tell you?
Right. Like, I usually wear saris. I'm a very traditional person. Sari, bindi, my mangalsutra and everything. So today I wanted a change. I just wore this ripped jeans, which was in the fashion, and a French braid and a young look. I wanted a different look, a makeover for myself. I'm usually not like this. I'm a very traditional person. I would look like that auntie sitting there. And she is a beautiful woman, a beautiful traditional Telugu lady, and I'm like her every day with my braid, with my bindi, my mangalsutra, my nice trimmed cotton sari. So my older son, who's 17 years, he said, Mom, I asked him, is it okay if I'm wearing the ripped jean? He said, Amma, whatever suits you, whatever you think you're looking decent in, whatever you think you're looking young, happy, content in, suits you perfectly, and you are perfect for the event. Just
wow.
Go.
So moms out here, feel young, be young, okay? Change your lifestyle, be fit, eat healthy. Thank you so much, Dr. Lakshmi. Now I have Dr. Kishore Alpati, who is an octo.
Of chatting time, the 15 minutes going and 15 minutes coming. Eventually, it got to a point where we got addicted to the gym. There are a few days I feel lazy, she will drag me to the gym, and there are a few days she feels lazy and I would drag her to the gym. But I think the point behind this, I know we're all concentrating on the mom, but to be able to push that mom, to be able to push that wife, to be able to push that mother-in-law, there has to be a son, husband, father, father-in-law who needs to be proactive. They need to be involved actively in their spouses or daughters or mother-in-law's health. They need to be able to push them to move forward. And I think that is a great backbone for a female to move forward in the society. There's always a woman behind a man, but I think at this point in time, in the evolution, I think there has to be a man behind a woman to make sure that the success is, that the world moves on, right? And another thing is, all women are innately beautiful. You can be a beautiful mom, you're a beautiful sister, you're a beautiful mother-in-law, whatever it is, it might not just be a physical beauty, but it has to be mental, it has to be alertness. You need to be able to look beautiful for the society, and that's what makes the family look beautiful. So to strive for that, I think you need to work actively, be part of your family, make sure you involve your husband or your sons. That's definitely a fun thing. It's an enjoyment, like you've seen. Pinky Roshan, got really active after she saw Hrithik Roshan got so, she's such a smart guy. And I think that is the take-home message from here. All of us need to be involved in the whole paradigm shift so that all of us stay healthy and the society moves on to be healthy. Thank you.
Dr. Raj Mathur, what do you have to say about this initiative? And thank you so much for joining hands with Million Moms and being our main sponsor.
Good afternoon to everybody. A hearty welcome on behalf of the Shahdan family. I hope you have enjoyed the lunch and the hospitality, what our college could gift to you all. Any shortcomings, I'm extremely pardoned to that. But our managing director, Dr. Sarib Rasul Khan, the young, dynamic person, he is always ready to help such events. And he is always shy to come on the stage. He pushes me, and I do his job. Anyway, that is about our institution. We will help you for such good causes every time. And this particular event is to my heart. Being a doctor, when everybody said about obesity and all, the moment you see me, you will definitely not agree with me what, how he has become a doctor has become like this. Honestly speaking, I was very thin. I was Mr. Wimble Adjust. I got number of prizes for my physique. But at that time, I used to take classes to my students. So my students were always wondering, who is the actual teacher? So I used to pray God that I should become fat. And God has become so kind, he has made me like this. Now I want to reduce. I have got thousands of students all over the world. Wherever I go, I request them, Baba, please make me thin. Don't do anything, make me thin. They say, sir, we like you this way only. Please be like this. When I told my managing director, I want to become thin, he said, sir, the seat in which you are sitting, it fits you, and nobody else is fitting in that seat. So that is my problem. But dear friends, please don't pray God so much that you will become like me. I am very happy that most of you are very good. Keep it up and never pray for becoming fat. Eat, manage your time well. As Madam has said rightly, you have to adjust everything accordingly. Before going into those steps of again doing exercise and all and reducing, it's better that take care from now onwards. But people will ask you, what is this, sir? We have got a small life. Let us live in this life. Enjoy. Anyway, when we die, again we will be born only 3 kgs or 4 kgs. So such type of questions are asked by my patients. Of course, right now, I think barring few, I am the oldest member here. I have got double retirement and still continuing. At least that much strength you must have to move about and enjoy life. Obesity. Moms are the best persons in the world. Ladies, without ladies, world is zero. In jungles, flowers are beautiful. In concrete jungles, women are the only beautiful persons. Without women, no house can run. And I honestly tell you, if a child becomes sick, both parents will run to the doctor. When women become sick, husband will run to the doctor because he cannot manage without her. But when husband becomes ill, wife tries to take him to hospital, he will only scold her back. I am all right. He will take one or two medicines and he will recover from that. And they are the persons who are responsible for bringing antibiotic resistance persons in the world. So please, my dear friends, enjoy life to the extent that don't go beyond limits. Be normal, be healthy, be good mothers. We had very good mothers, mother only, not mothers. And my wife is a good mother, my children are good mothers. So please continue that and be fit. Don't become patients of endocrinologists. My family have got also endocrinologists and orthopedicians. Many orthopedicians are my students, many endocrinologists are my students, but still I have to go because I am suffering now. So all the best to you all. May God bless all of you. Again, once again, greetings from Shahdan and Dr. Sarib Rasul Khan.
Thank you so much, very, very much. Thank you so much, Doctor. It was very hilarious, especially the way you are actually telling all these points, but still there's an in-depth, intense message in whatever you said. And I'm sure all the moms out here have got the message straight. Thank you so much, Doctor. Now I have my colleague with me, Manjulata Kalanidhi, who is also a journalist. She's the editor of New India Express. Manjulata, I'm sure you must have experienced or encountered many people who on and off come and complain to you that, you know, I'm obese, I didn't know how to reduce my weight, or, you know, and there are so moms around you also. You've got many mothers as your friends.
Yes.
So what do you have to say about this initiative and how do you wish to take it forward? Because you're a journalist, you're the one who can actually spread the message across.
Yes. Let me start on a funny note. There is this Indian dress called the nightie. You know, the nightie is the dirtiest piece of clothing in Indian tradition. I have seen that when you wear that nightie, you become so comfortable with yourself. It covers every part of you. When you put that, you just switch on your TV and you're very comfortable. The moment that that dress is banned, you know, suddenly you wear a t-shirt and maybe a jeans, you know, and track pants, it hits you that, oh my God, look at me, look at my thighs, look at my body. It sort of hits you. It makes you feel very athletic. I myself had a reality check, you know, about 3 years ago, I was in Singapore and trying to do this ziplining. And when I went there, he said, madam, can I know your weight? I was like, why am I so fat? He said, nahi, ab thoda dikhte ho. I'm not sure, I'll need to check whether you can go on it. That sort of hit me. I thought, oh my God, this guy is a stranger and he thinks I'm overweight. So that's it. Once I came back, that was my 40th birthday. I thought, okay, now this is time to sort of put things on. So ever since that, I made Shilpa Shetty my best friend. Her video of 40 minutes of yoga is very, very helpful. Every day, 7:30, I send my daughter to school. And then I switch on that, close the door, and I manage to do 40 minutes of yoga. And I can tell you that I have seen a lot of change in myself. I can sleep better. I can wake up better. And it's just a matter of prioritizing. I mean, you just have to plan things out. If you, for example, you want to eat healthy food, then how do you eat healthy food? You'll have to plan, perhaps soak up things, you know, do your sprouts or whatever it takes. And you'll have to carry food from home. So before you probably have your lunch, pack your dabba, put it for your box. And luckily I'm blessed to have a three, you know, I live in a third floor apartment. We don't have a lift. Previously people would say, oh, that's so sad. But now I realize that apartment choice has made me, you know, at least run up around 700 steps every day. I do it 4 times to, you know, sort of send out somebody, come back and all. So basically it's all about prioritizing. There is absolutely no choice whether you like it or you don't like it. Fitness is something that you have to do in whatever way, whatever works. Like they all said, it's Zumba, somebody might like yoga, somebody might like walking, but it has to be there. And if you're a working mom and you're in a regular shift, I suggest that you should finish it before many, the earliest thing. In fact, first thing you should do is probably exercise, because during the day you get very, very busy. I have been doing it myself. I know I have a long way to go to get fit, but I can say that I enjoy good health despite my weight. So just keep yourself in priority and that works.
Thank you so much, Manjunatha. So before we close, I want to have a last word from each of you. So what do you think about Million Moms, and in which way can you actually, you know, take this forward, one by one? One by one.
I think it's a wonderful initiative by Dr. Pavitra. Getting the moms fit is getting the entire society to be fit and healthy. So I sincerely hope and wish that this movement continues. It goes on for generations, and keeping her in mind, this would evolve as a worldwide event as we move on. Thank you so much.
Before we go to Dr. Lakshmi, I request Abhishek Shaurav, car number 53, to please come over here and meet here. Okay, Dr. Lakshmi.
I think it's a great initiative, nothing more to say. Everybody has been praising, it's a wonderful initiative. All I want to say is to all your moms, all the women at home, all the obese people, all those people who are not fit, maybe you're thin, very good looking, but you're not fit. Tell each other that you have to be fit. Always encourage each other. It may be a mom, dad, brother, sister, your gatekeeper, my security person has big belly. So I tell him, you have to work, you have to, you know, take a few steps. So the point here is take a few steps from this sofa to that sofa to this sofa, little bit, few steps. Few steps will bring 100 points of sugar down. Few steps will bring your fertility back. Few steps will bring your menses back. Few steps will save the bone against osteoporosis. Few steps will make your joints more supple and flexible. Few steps. That's all.
I always feel that out of sight is out of mind. So having a support group like Million Moms is a very practical thing, because every day you can see conversations happening on social media. You can see there is a mail that is sent to everybody who is subscribed to the 21-day challenge, which is very interesting. It tells you, have you done this? Why don't you do this? It's in a very gentle way, it sort of nudges you to get onto the fitness track. So it's great that there is a support system like this, and you can discuss so many things with your peer. So I hope Million Moms will touch its million figure very shortly.
Well, I have told enough, but I tell you one thing. All the ladies who are sitting here, every day you ask, if you are married to your husband or any male member, that how am I looking? They will definitely say if you are fat or thin, then you can do something to reduce. This formula I have seen with my wife. Whenever she sees me, she asks me, how am I looking? Am I fat? Immediately I say, yes, you're looking little fat. Then she will reduce. So that is the best formula. Adopt it and you will be successful. Thank you.
The mirror image of mom is wow. And I'm sure every mother or every woman or every human being would want to be wow. Every individual's health is important. It is not only a woman, but here we women have neglected our health. That's the reason why this Million Moms here. And I thank Mani Pavitra and her team for bringing up this. And as my part, I would definitely initiate all the women whom I know to take interest in their health. And I would definitely try to promote this as much as possible, Pavitra, from my end. I will definitely see that all the women I know will take up this challenge. And I'll definitely see that my children also will they be health conscious. And one small request is to the children here, all the mothers, when we children go home, even now, even after I'm 45 years old, even if I go home now, my mom cooks what I like. She doesn't cook what she likes till late. But we never go home and ask mom if she had her lunch. After we come back from our school, college, or after I go back from office, when I go home, I don't ask my mom if she has eaten or no. Like this, most of the children are there. So I request all the children, whatever age you are, when you go back home, just check if your mother has had a lunch, her dinner, or whatever it is. And if she has not had, make sure that you all have it together. and see that she is healthy. And once she is healthy, we all are definitely going to be healthy. So let us spread this healthiness amongst all of us. Thank you, Pavitra, for giving me this opportunity. And thank you, each and every individual who has come here has definitely taken up this as a challenge. And I'm sure you people will spread it across. Let us spread this smiles of healthiness amongst all of us. Thank you, each one and all.
The other day, I met one 75 years old emeritus professor, urologist from America. There was some discussion about mothers. I lost my mother 1.5 years back. So he said, in the world, everything can be replaced, but for mother. You cannot replace mother with anything. The great initiation that is taken by Pavitra and Prema, they have seen so many social causes. Most of them were for more of a publicized thing. Honestly, let me be, I'm a little open, please don't mistake me. This cause really touched me when they called me. I said that I want to participate. But unfortunately, morning I was supposed to attend. There was some assault on four people at Bidar. One person died and the other three people were brought to me. There was some misunderstanding. They thought that these people were trying to abduct or kidnap some children in Bidar. So I was operating them since morning. So I was held up. Sorry, I could not make it.
That will take care of your health. And I see very young people here, not many old people. I think most of them are teen, about teen, something like that. And some of them are young mothers. But you do have mothers at home. Take home a message. Take care of your mother. She will take care of the entire society. That's all. Mother is not confined to one family. Mother is confined to the country. She is above all, she is on par with God. Thank you very much.
I request all the panelists to be here for just 2 minutes. We have Mr. Raunak. I request Mr. Raunak to please come on to the dais and hand over the mementos to the guests on the panelists on the dais. Please come. Dr. Dashad Ramir. Madam Kolli Madhavi garu, please. Dr. Mathur. Dr. Manjula. Dr. Kishore. Request the guest to please be seated for 2 minutes. 2 minutes. One talk.
Really needs a huge round of applause here is Mr. Pradeep for having been behind Dr. Pavitra, ran so many things, the person in the backbone, who's always behind the curtains. I would assume this is the first time I met him in the morning, but I'm sure the effort he has put in today is amazing.
Yeah, very true, absolutely true. I totally agree to this. Okay, I request Dr. Javed, who is a forensic medicine professor of Shahjahan Institute of Medical Sciences, to please come over to the dais, and he wishes to just throw some insight on the college. It's 2 minutes.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure and an honor on the behalf of Shahjahan Institutions, group of institutions which comprise of around 59 institutions from KG to PG, and in hosting this event here, the terminal event rather. Taking up of the terminal event, our chairman, beloved chairman, Dr. Wizada Rasool Khan, was the force behind the establishment of these group of institutions. And we have got 4 medical colleges across 2 states, which are turning around 550 doctors per year. And then several other institutions, including engineering, pharmacy, and all those are involved. And the driving force, or the Brahmasthalam, or whatever you call, or Kendra Bindu, which they call in Sanskrit, is Madam Shahjahan. Please give her a hand for it, because she is the most deserving mom. And she is popularly known among the students as Shahjahan mom. If they are not able to face up with certain problems, they run to her. So it's the force behind this whole group of institutions which is running this show. And speaking of moms, or million moms, or more mom, the thing is, I'll relate my personal experience. When my mother died, I felt that I'm almost half dead. Nobody to advise me, and nobody to take care of me. So that was the situation. Anyway, on the lighter tone, I think it's the men who make the women the mom. That's it. Okay, on a lighter tone, I thank you all. Thank you.
Okay, before we close the today's event, yeah, 1 minute.
Well, as Dr. Javed said, Shahjahan Madam, whose name this institution is there, she is the wife of Dr. Wizarat Rasool Khan, who is the founder chairman. And this lady is so dedicated. She is the real mother of 4 children, but all the students of Shahjahan Institute of Medical Sciences, they call her mom. And that gives her the strength to run this institution. She comes at 8:15 in the morning and goes back 4:30 after all the students go. And last message, all women must drink every day at least a glass of milk to be away from him.
Yes, sir, you are. You are. You are absolutely right, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Okay, I request the participants of this card numbers to please come over here and please submit your cards. Yeah, competition number 35, 67, 71, 69, 74, 61, 44, and 49. I repeat, 35, 67, 71, 69, 74, 61, 44, and 49. Now I request the lady of the event, Dr. Mani Pavitra, the founder of Million Moms, to please come over the dais and take the program forward.
Thank you so much, Prema. Yeah. So now is the time for awards. How many of you are waiting eagerly for to know who the winners are? Everyone? Oh, awesome. Very good. So now we go with the next one. We had a category with maximum number of social media posts. And it definitely goes to Rajeshwari Kalyanam, Reshmi, and Manjula Sakalanidhi. I would request all of you to come on stage, please. And I would request the principal, Sir Ram Mathur sir, to hand over the awards to these ladies. They have been buzzing non-stop from the moment they registered to just before coming here. These guys were going, all their walls were about the messages about social, about Million Moms. Give them a big round of applause, guys. Each one, one. But also, they created a prop, and the prop had a social message, and there's so, like, every single category of award that we had announced, these ladies had put in the effort, they took the time out, and they participated in all categories. So let me welcome on stage, card number 3, Mohita, Anamika, Yashashwini, and Mahesh. Give them a big round of applause, guys! And you won't believe it, the way she was buzzing. She helped me with organizing, she helped me with motivating people. You just name it, every single category she had participated. So big round of applause. As an organizer, when you start out alone, people like her give a big shot in the arms for us. Thank you. And also, they have a wonderful message. The difference between who you are and who you want to be is what you do. The difference between who you are and who you want to be is what you do. They just didn't write that quote. They proved it by being in every single aspect. Guys, kudos to you. Big round of applause, guys, once again. When we talk about fitness, we talk about it. We do awareness sessions. Now is the time to go beyond awareness sessions and be part of the movement of doing it. And these guys had reflected it so wonderfully well. Thank you. And there was one more. Yes, yes. Vinita and? Vinita and Nitin. I think it is Mayank and team. Do come on. Come on. Where are you from? Let me see your props. Get the props. There, outside. Okay, come on. Come. You have to say what you did in the morning.
It was wonderful to play this game. And a great thing. I think Million Moms is a great idea. Thank you so much.
Our props was dumbbells, for those who don't know. So we just wanted to give this message that all the moms should be fit to show that we just carry dumbbells.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Ram Mathur sir. Please be seated. Now I would request Dr. Dashrath Ram Garu to give the next set of awards. There are two doctors who participated
in this challenge. They are very, very busy, you know, like they don't have a single minute. But they came forward because I was requesting all the doctors to give away messages relevant to their field. And we have two doctors who had actually followed it. That is Dr. Sumi and Dr. Bhavani. Do we have Dr. Bhavani over here? Dr. Bhavani and family, please come over. She is such a busy doctor. She practices in Kukatpally. She's a homeopathy doctor. But you should see the way she decked up her car. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your time and also giving out a beautiful social message. Do you have Dr. Sunil here? Dr. Sunil? No? Okay, thank you. So, that's it for all the small prizes. I think now the big awards are in waiting. Do we have the podium finishes ready? Do we have the podium finishes ready? No? Okay, meanwhile, I would like to thank a lot of people. Yeah. Guys, how did you like today's program? Good, you liked it? You want more of this from us? Yes? You know what our next program is going to be? Yes? Independence Day? Yes, we are doing Mom's Day Out. Yeah, the next one is going to be Mom's Day Out. We'll just show you a small promo with respect to that.
నాకు 40 ఏళ్ళు, ఉద్యోగం చేస్తున్నాను, ఇంటి పనంతా నేనే చేసుకోవాల్సి వస్తుంది. ఆదరబాదరా హడావిడి, క్షణం తీరిక లేని పని. ఆఫీస్కి రోజూ లేటే. ఇద్దరు పిల్లలున్నా ఇంటడు చాకిరి నాపైనే. విసుగొస్తుంది. కాసేపు రిలాక్స్ అవుదామన్నా పరిస్థితులు సహకరించవు. ఇంకెంతకాలం ఇలా ఒక మెషిన్ లాగా? నాకంటూ ఒక లైఫ్ లేదా? అప్పుడే నా ఫోన్ మోగింది. ఆశ్చర్యం, అమోఘం, ఊహించలేంది జరిగింది. నా ఆనందానికి అవధులే లేవు.
నాకు 25 ఏళ్ళు, 9 నెలల పాప. అమ్మతని ఎంత మధురంగా ఉంటుందో ప్రతి క్షణం అనుభవిస్తున్నాను. కానీ పొద్దున్న లేస్తే పడుకునే వరకు క్లీనింగ్, వాషింగ్, ఫీడింగ్ ఇదే సరిపోతుంది. నీరసం వస్తుంది. ఆనందం ఒకవైపు, అలసట మరోవైపు. కాసేపు అలా రెస్ట్ తీసుకోవాలని ఉంటుంది. కొంచెం రిలాక్స్ అవుదామనిపిస్తుంది. కానీ ఇంతలో ఒక మెసేజ్ వచ్చింది నా ఫోన్కి. అది చూసి నేను మా ఆయన క్షణం పాటు ఎంతో ఎక్సైట్ అయ్యాం. బట్ పాపను వదిలి ఎలా? డోంట్ వరీ, ఐఎమ్ దేర్ అన్న మా ఆయన మాటలు నాకు కొండంత బలాన్నిచ్చాయి.
నాకు 50 ఏళ్ళు, ఇంటి పని, వంట పని చేసుకుంటూ ఇల్లే ప్రపంచంగా బతకడం అలవాటైంది. పాతికేళ్ల కొడుకే నా లోకం, నా సర్వస్వం. వాడి చుట్టే నా జీవితం. కానీ నేను కూడా ఏదో చేయాలి. కాసేపు అన్నీ మర్చిపోయి అంతా పక్కన పెట్టి హాయిగా రిలాక్స్ అవ్వాలి. నా కోసం బతకాలి అని అనిపిస్తూ ఉంటుంది అప్పుడప్పుడు. అప్పుడే నా కొడుక్కి ఎవరో మెసేజ్ చేశారు, నాలాంటి ఎంతోమంది అమ్మల కోసం ఒక అందమైన ప్రపంచం ఉందంట. నేను నమ్మలేదు. ఆ ప్రపంచంలోకి నన్ను తీసుకెళ్తానన్నాడు నా కొడుకు. అసలు అలాంటి ప్రపంచం ఉంటుందా? ఎస్, ఉంది. అదే మిలియన్ మామ్స్ చేపట్టిన మామ్స్ డే అవుట్ ప్రపంచం. అమ్మలకే అమ్మ ఒడి ఇది. ఆట పాట మాట మంతి యోగా వ్యాయామం రిలాక్సేషన్ ఆరోగ్యకరమైన వంటలు అన్నీ ఉంటాయి. అమ్మలని లాలించే మమతల లోగిలి మామ్స్ డే అవుట్.
Holiday. You go to a work, you get a holiday off, either a Saturday or a Sunday, you know, at least few hours a day someone gets an off. But mom is someone who does all through. She doesn't even think of a break. She wants to buy something, she would rather buy for her kid. If she wants to cook something, she would rather cook for her kid. If there are no kids at home, she would not cook, she would stop cooking. When they want to go out, she would rather not go out. You know, the first response you tell a mother to take a break, she'll find it very funny. She will never do it. It's up to us to motivate our mothers to take time out for themselves. In this fast-paced world, before we had a village to support a mom. We had a combined family to support a mom with various tasks. But in the current day, the entire burden is, you know, it's imbalanced. It's totally falling on the shoulders of only one person in the family, and that is a mother. Imagine a machine, also if it works non-stop without any break, it breaks out. And we are just human beings. So it's time, take time out for yourself to think of your own health. And that is what Moms Day Out, through Moms Day Out program, we are trying to communicate. So how do you think, how do you like it? Good. So I think every month at least once we should have one day out. How many of you agree? Yes? Okay, let's, if you agree, shout out after me. Let's have Mom's Day Out. Okay, repeat. Let's have
Mom's Day Out.
Let's have
Mom's Day Out.
Let's have
Mom's Day Out.
It's time we take that break, because in this fast-paced world, if you're not taking that break from that social media, from that constant, you know, information overload that we are being jam-packed with, we'll break down. And let it not be another Sonali Bindra in waiting, where we're so busy that we don't even know what's happening within us. You need a break to just take care of your own self. And there's so many places which are offering. I'm not saying Million Moms is doing it. There's so many places which are offering it outside. Take a break and rejuvenate at least once a month. Okay, guys? I think the podium finishes. The awards are taking time to announce. So I would like to, before we finish, I would like to tell you the story of how this program happened. Can you believe the amount of money I spent on this whole program? Can you guess? It's 25 lakh worth program.
This whole day and the 1 month of campaign which was there, the total worth of it is 25 lakhs. Yes, but I didn't spend more than 2 lakhs from my pocket because there's so many people who came forward. When we say Million Moms is Pavitra, I don't
agree to it at all. I am just, I just have that intention. My intention is fueled by so many people, you won't even believe it. Novotel had given the venue for free. Shadan guys, all this which you see, they have given it for free. Every single thing. And you know, some people when they give it for free, they feel like owning you. But you won't believe what this college has done. I don't even know them before this program. They called me one night and they wanted to know what I'm doing. I went and I gave a presentation. Within five minutes, the decision was taken to support this. How many people in this world do it, yeah? To our own family members, we don't give. If we have to give 10,000 rupees to our own family members, we think 101 times. And these guys, within 5 minutes, they took the decision. All this, I didn't ask them. They planned it. In my schedule, I didn't have food because I didn't have money for organizing food. All that I wanted was to bring out a strong social message. I'm not someone with deep pockets to spend. I just have that intention to do it. But my intention is just growing with the support of amazing people like this. Sir, when Sarip sir spoke to me, he said, Pavitra, how is the schedule? I said, sir, we're starting at Novotel and we're ending at Novotel because Novotel guys are giving the venue for free and they'll put out the counter out, some money, like people can buy the food over there. He said, no, Pavitra, let's end it at Shadan. I'll take care of the food. I'll take care of all the arrangements. How many people would say that, yeah?
There's so many of you who have paid the initial money, all the money which was paid, we had directly paid the rally organizers, the FMCI license and all of that. But most of you were sponsored by someone. And all of you were sponsored by Shadan. Shadan Institute of Medical Sciences. Every single one of you who came here, your money was paid by Shadan Institute of Medical Sciences. And you know who made it possible? It's Bina Singh. Bina, I called her when I wanted to organize this. I said, Bina, you know what? I want all doctors to talk about this because they are the ones who are already doing such good work for the society. I want them to talk. She said, okay, yeah, I know Shadan guys, let's talk. But she forgot all about it. Suddenly, 2 weeks before the event, I called her, Bina, I'm doing this event, why don't you come over? She said, oh, I forgot, I'll connect you to them. Within three days, they took care of everything else. Okay, so it's not everyone does this. You know, one organization was in touch with me for one whole month. They were calling me, they were talking. They wanted to give money. They wanted to sponsor a huge amount. But they didn't understand the message. They wanted to kill it. They wanted their branding. They wanted to propagate, give clothes and I don't know what all. Million Moms is a very pure concept. Here, I'm not doing this for money. I'm earning good enough money to sustain my family. My husband is doing a lot of work. But for me, the most important thing is to spread the message. Every mother should be cared for. If not now, it's never going to happen. As a society, all of you present over here, I would request you to take the pledge. Please go out there and support at least one mother. At least take care of your own self. Take care of your own mother. It is so important because each one of us is going to contribute. If I would have thought, okay, I'm fit enough, it's enough. And if I would have slept at home, this wouldn't have happened. And I'm not, this is only happening because of the intention. Shadan guys had supported all of you who have come sponsored into the program. You should thank Shadan Medical College. And Dr. Nasi, I fall short of words to talk about the support he has given. Yesterday, J Media guys have supported us with this event. All the LED, the stage, everything is given by J Media. It's one of the biggest movie event organization company. I didn't pay for any of it. My intention is there. I'm repeating this again and again because I want you to understand the power of your intention. If you decide to change something, you can do it. You don't need truckloads of money. You just have to have the right intention and people will come and support and will push you forward. The entire event production was taken care by the J Media guys. Someone said they would help them with the money, but they backed out. But these guys, they didn't back out. He went to China. He came back only to support this event today. But I couldn't ask them for more because I knew they were in some trouble. They just sponsored 4 flexis and I was thinking, what should I do? How will people know the message? And again, I came to the college here there were a lot of stands which were lying around. And I said, Nasi, can I please take them? I'll just put the flexi and I want the message to spread. And immediately he spoke, Dr. Nasi spoke to Dr. Sareeb Rasool Khan. Again, within half an hour, they organized a DCM and they sent all the empty stands to the person who had to make the flexis. How many of us will do that, yeah? It's amazing. I don't have words for the kind of support. Till midnight, 1:32, they sat and organized all these chairs. And they're not making a single penny out of doing this. It's their pure intent of supporting this cause that they're doing it. Okay? Again, I'm saying this again and again. Your intention is enough. Today, you decide. Take care of your health. Take care of someone's health. That is going to make a lot of difference. Intention is... My good friend, Dheeraj Mirani, all the social media work, everything is done, it's done by him. And guess what? He paid for his car. He registered for his own car. There are a lot of people who just want to come free. But this guy, in spite of doing all the work, he paid for his own car and today he's here. Thank you, Dheeraj. Every minute, his whole team supported me and I just give him one call. That this is not done. I have so many complaints because I want a very good product out. But so patiently your team has handled, and thank you for all the support. Then Manisha Kapoor, she is the reason for spreading this word. She is the reason for taking this message to the social circle. I have never been part of any social circle all my life. All that I know, I was a very studious student at school. I used to study very hard, and after I got married, my only duty was my husband, my kids, my own health, and it was a limited thing. I never got into social circles, I never went out, partied, but Manisha came forward and she said, Pavitra, whatever, whomever you need, I'm going to get you to your event. How many of you can say that, yeah? More than 20 cars today were mobilized by her single-handedly, and for the past whole month, talked to people every single day. Just to get them to this event so that they can experience what Million Moms is. So I would from the bottom of my heart thank Manisha Kapoor for doing this. And Precious Escapes, our main gift sponsor. Again, that is a sponsor. He sponsored more than 1 lakh worth awards. And that is for the podium finishes. Venkateshwar Garu, are you here? Venkateshwar sir, please come on stage sir. Guys, give him a big round of applause. To people like him, I can't give anything back. Even my thank you falls short. Thank you so much, sir, for supporting the cause. The day I announced this event, Manisha said, Pavitra, people will come only if they have big awards. And I'm like, shit, yaar, your big awards, make a house a liquor home. From where will I get 1 lakh and all that heavy amount? I don't have that amount. And I called sir. And I didn't even ask him, okay? One moment, madam, I'll sponsor 50,000 for the first prize winners. Second prize winners, I'll sponsor. He got 3 other sponsors. The fire safety people, the half sugar people. Sir, please come over. Mr. Ramesh and Mr. Raghavachari from half sugar. Fire safety is nowhere related to our event. Yet, they came forward just to support the cause. So, if we have the right intent, there are wonderful people out there with a good heart. And every day, both the sirs used to talk to people just to get money to take this forward. Thank you so much.
Good evening, everyone. Many congratulations for the winners and many congratulations for all the participants who have participated for a good cause. Let me tell you 1 minute of my association with Dr. Mani Pavitra. We all started the journey in BNI way back 2 years back. The journey is still continuing. And the moment Dr. Mani Pavitra has called me, Venkat, this is what the thing. I think hardly I spent about a minute. I told her immediately, yes, we are on Precious Escapes Holidays. We are on board with you. How many more sponsors you want? Then I brought in my friend, Mr. Ramesh Garu Vinjamuri from VR Fire Safety. Then I brought Half Sugar, Vicolabs into this event. and make sure that they see everybody, the mother is a mother plays a vital role. I have seen many programs of Dr. Mani Pavitra, all are inspiring to our family, especially the mother today, in fact I have already sent a write-up. My mother played a very important role. So, as a mark of respect, yes. And moreover, our journey has started now. Many more programs which we are going to participate. Thank you, Dr. Mani.
Thank you so much, sir. Without their support, it wouldn't have taken off, guys. So give them a big round of applause. And then today, the morning nuts which you had, which you were eating, they were sponsored by Maunika. She is a CA by profession. She bought the nuts for everyone. She said, ma'am, I want to give snacks. She did my 21-day challenge. She motivated more than 200 mothers to take up the challenge. Yes, and today all the snacks, she herself, as an individual, she's not a company, nothing. But still she went ahead and sponsored. So I would like to thank her. Guys, just think of Monica. She's not here. She has a small baby. She had gone home in between the drive. And Suvarna Alapati. We have Suvarna here. Again, Suvarna is another one of my 21-day challenge participants. From morning 7 o'clock, she was the first person to come in. She took care of the food for everyone. All organization, everything. Even she has a small baby. But she wanted to contribute in some form or other. And she was the one who handled all the food arrangements. Thank you, Suvarna. And Sandeep and Neerja Singh, where do we have them? The rally organizers. They are busy in calculation. I think they are very busy with the calculation. Every single detail of the rally was handled by them. Right from police permissions. You know the number of permissions that we have to take for this? More than 15 permissions from 5 different police stations. And you know how they stop us? Every step of the way there is interrogation. Who's doing it? What is happening? What? This, that. And everything was handled by Sandeep and Neerja Singh. Guys, give them a big round of applause. From morning 7 o'clock to night 11 o'clock, non-stop is spent in the police station for the past few days. So, you want to say something?
I guess we take pride being here, you know, and we are so proud to be associated with you. We did our bit, and it's all about doing each of us our own bit, and I guess the society will be wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks, Sandeep. And most importantly, our doctors, Dr. Dashrath Ramgaru, Dr. Lakshmi, Dr. Kishore, their videos were phenomenal. I mean, they motivated me like nothing else, you know. I had this vision where I wanted every doctor from every specialty to talk about how fitness would help moms from their own perspective. These guys, they gave us time. They were on schedule. They helped us record. All our initial messages were sent. They took time out. They put in so much effort and they delivered the message. That is what your message has motivated a lot of people, sir. Thank you so much for taking the time out. Thank you. And where are we? Plan a plant, Divyanjali. All the plants today are again sponsored by Divyanjali. Where is Divyanjali? Come over. She just came in touch. She heard of the event 3 days back. She messaged me, I want to give gifts to everyone. How many gifts do you need? I said, no, I don't need anything. You tell me how much you can give. And she's the one who sponsored the gifts. Thank you so much, Divyanjali.
From Planet Plant, it's a privilege to be a part here, part of this event. I truly believe mother is the backbone of the family, and I actually am motivated by the cause Mani Pavitra is driving. So from my end, I would definitely motivate few more women I know, all the women I know, to join Million Moms. Thank you so much. He's my husband, Ganesh, who is always behind me, because without which I wouldn't be here in front of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And guys, each and every one of you sitting over here, I'm so sorry we had to put you through a lot of waiting.
we had to keep you hungry for some time. I really apologize for all the delays that have happened from our side because we had to fulfill certain formalities for FMSCI. Though time speed distance, it's an innovative concept. In order to organize it, there are a lot of formalities. And I'm so sorry that you had to bear with all of us for the number of calls that we made. And you know, you had to wait in the morning. And my entire team, Kavya, Shyam, they have been, in the last 2 weeks, they were, come over, Kavya and Shyam, come over. I don't know what I would have done without them. Kavya and Shyam, Kavya was coordinating every single person, it's not a joke. For us to fill one single document, we take so long. These guys, not only people who came here, people who didn't come, 20 more cars were there who were supposed to come. Every single paperwork was filled. There were four teams who were going around the city just to collect the paperwork. 2 weeks time, morning to night, we did nothing but talk to people on phone just to coordinate with the paperwork. And it's all because of these two guys. Thank you. Without these two guys, none of you would be part of the rally because they were the ones who filled the forms and who made it happen. Thank you so much, guys. And also, like I said, I apologize to each and every one of you for all the formality related delays that you had to go through. But because you're already here, there is one request. What is the action that you're going to take today after this program? We have done all this for a purpose. It's not just to create noise. Noise we can create in many ways. We don't have to organize such big events. Why do we need people like you out here? It's because we need doers. We need action takers. We need someone who goes beyond just talking and saying about things. We need someone, at least people like who have taken the time out to spend a whole day with us. I think your intentions are in the right place that you have come to support this cause. Can you take action today? Can you take 2 minutes? For 2 minutes of silence, 2 minutes of pin drop silence, and think, what is it that you're going to do today? I want doing. I don't want awareness. There's so much information overload. You put in one word in Google, you'll get 100 different articles on information. Information is not what we need. Awareness is not what is needed. What is needed is to take action. Are we ready to take that action?
I was actually prepared for this. Hi, this is Praful, and I want my mom and wife to be here, and hope everyone agree with this. I made a check-like thing, which is to one of the mom, which is Mani Pavitra ji, for all the blessings, and the thing which we have witnessed today is priceless. So I just want to give this away from my mom to the person who has taken this initiative. I just got it with me, it was a flow of thought, I just wanted to implement it today. And with me today, I have my mom and my wife.
What is your
it's all about initiatives. Pavitra ji keeps inspiring all moms, all, yes. This is from all mom and to the initiative actually which we have taken. So this is actually, we have got it for you. Yeah. I'll keep my mom and wife busy by doing what is their like first preference, what they like, and I'll make them restart again, like from these school days. Go back, take a brief and restart that one thing which they always wanted to do, and just go ahead with that.
So Praful is going to make both his wife and mom take one thing that they love to do. Okay, so let's ask them, what is that one thing that they love to do?
Thanks, Pavitra, to organize so beautiful event today.
I'm happy by coming over here. And I started my journey with Pavitra only. I started doing work with Pavitra. Now I'm started doing my own work. Thanks to Pavitra only.
What is it like? What is that one thing you want to do so that he's going to support
you in life? He is supporting. I'm trying to do my own work in events and by doing online works. Just started. I'll come back with a good result with my husband only.
So, Praful, Shika wants to get back to work and Praful is going to support her with that. Awesome. He wants to support you. Use the opportunity. So this is the problem with Indian moms. When we are given the opportunity, we say, nahi karna hai hame. No, it's okay. No, it's not okay. You need to do it. Just pick it up. Yeah.
My mother-in-law is also very supportive. She helps me in everywhere, whenever I need. Like if I'm putting a stall, she helps me a lot. She takes her kids very well.
So how are you going to support her?
I'll be supporting her in any way, whatever she wants, whenever she wants help.
She makes some handwork, like moti work, she does very well. So I'll definitely make sure that she runs an online store on a social media, and I'll encourage her in that. In health again, yeah. She started already working on her health through a platform of me and mom, through Sachi Maheshwari, as you'll be knowing. So she is already in touch with her. And she'll take a long way. Like, I'll make sure that it takes a long way.
So Ani has started coaching with my fellow coach, Sachi Maheshwari. She's taking personal coaching with her. So he's going to support her with that. Awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, guys. Are you all ready with your answers?
Very good afternoon, girls, especially moms. I don't want to call you moms, but girls today. And the youngest one is standing right beside us, and I'm sure, ma'am, thank you so much. I'm sure you're all an inspiration. I just saw some of the youngest ones here. Thanks a lot. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Mani and husband and the entire team, crew, everyone. I've seen them relentlessly work towards the entire initiative, so my gratitude towards them for having this as an. And if you wanted my action plan, the first thing is, I think I'm going to go online and log on to 21 days challenge. That would be my first action plan. Thank you. And apart from that, the message that we came in here is Unbound Learn is a company that I own. It's a training company. And when I say Unbound Learn, I just say that let's not limit learning to any restrictions, age, caste, creed, bar, especially mothers. So now the focus here is anyone, like I think Praful just shared that he wants to help his wife get back to work. I'm sure there are lots of people who want to get back to work but don't know where to start. There are lots of moms, now their kids have grown up and now they don't have any responsibility, so they're scared where to start from. That is where Unbound Learn comes with the picture. Me and our team here, Shrikant and Nanda, we would want to start a train-the-trainer program for mothers. I think training is one of the domains where mothers can pitch in very quickly, very easily at their flexi times, not devoting the entire day, but at least have some of the assignments which can financially be fit. When we talk about health, fitness, I think mental fitness and financial fitness also come into the picture. So if there are any women out here who want to get back into career, especially in terms of training, and we would start with colleges like Shadan, I'm sure, and who can support mothers for their first break, and then later on, there is no limit. And that would be one of the initiatives that I am going to be connected with Pavitra as well. And I'm sure anyone who is interested, please drop in a line. We're going to organize this and take it very big. Thank you so much. Congratulations, Pavitra. This has been a wonderful, successful event.
Thank you so much, Bama. Yeah, Rishmi, come on. So, in the morning she came and she told me, we want to get my mothers back into workforce. Pavitra, how can we collaborate? I said, let's meet up, let's see the work done and we can take it forward. So thank you, Mama, for that.
Hi, everyone. At the outset, I'd like to thank Dr. Mani Pavitra, because what she's done is really, really big. I didn't really imagine this on such a huge scale when I enrolled for it. And thanks to Manjulata Kalanidhi for getting me here. So I've not been much of a speaker, but I'll just try to tell you whatever I have to say. See, hearing Dr. Mani Pavitra speak, I was just reminded of this ad many years ago. There was an ad featuring a mom who's caring for her daughter for everything. She says, "Oh, you're getting weak. Why don't you have milk? And you're feeling low. Why don't you have some iron?" And she gives her badam and all that. But then she's not caring for her own feet. And the daughter says, "Mama, sab kuch jante hai, lekin khud ke liye care nahi karte." You know, that's what is the story of every mother today. We care so much about the kids, but we don't really take time out for ourselves. So it will be a great thing if we can get out and, you know, get insights into various things. And I mean, you actually get inspired from each other. So it's nice to see the participation of so many people here, so many mommies who actually come here. So the action I'm going to take is probably care more for my mother-in-law, mother, and give them more time, because back home my mother-in-law is caring. When I'm here, she's taking care of my kid. So so I will motivate more women like her, so they also come out and get their time out and they care about themselves. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rashmi. Rashmi is the associate editor of the Sakshi newspaper, and in spite of her busy schedule, she's here with us just to spread the message about Million Moms. Thank you so much. Anyone else wants to come?
I know it's been quite some time that all of you have been here. I won't take much time. Today, I would like to pledge that I will take care of my health as well as my family's health and my friends' health too. But along with this, I think I'm in a different platform than in politics, where we interact with leaders and all the parties. So from my end, I would definitely try to see that on whichever platform I can, I will see that they know the importance of women, women's health, and I see that we change the mindset of all the lawmakers we have. So I will try to do my best in every platform that I can, let it be on the televisions or anywhere else also, within the party internal meetings also. I will see that they give importance to women's health and try to change the mindset of the people who don't feel that women's health is important. I will see that I'll just try my bit. So the first step starts from today. I will do my best from what I can. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Madhurika. You know, when we talk about all these things, you know, change and all, the power which a politician has in policy making, in influencing decisions, is immense. We can't even imagine. It's immense. And I'm so grateful that you decided to do that, because in India, that is the most neglected topic. It doesn't exist anywhere. UK government is doing a huge awareness activity only on physical activity. It's a government activity. Here, because there is no government doing it, people like me have to do it. But if you support and if you talk about it at different platforms, I'm sure the change is going to happen from the government side. Thank you so much. Thank you. What is the action you're going to take today? Dr. Noor? Can we have you on stage, please?
Good afternoon, everyone. And firstly, I would like to congratulate Dr. Mani Pavitra for taking this great initiative to create fitness and health awareness among moms. This was a much needed initiative in the city. I remember very well, my mother was diagnosed with diabetes mellitus around 10 years back. And one of the reasons why the doctors said that she was she developed that condition was because of her sedentary lifestyle. So I did something that would any responsible son would do. I started taking my mom for a morning walk. So every morning, I typically, being typically Hyderabadi, I used to wake up at 9 a.m. every day, just in time to make it to my college classes. I was studying medicine at that time. So I started getting up at 6 in the morning. And I made it a point that I forced my mom to come out with me for a walk and put on some weight, and the thing paid off in the long run. Initially, she was on medication for 1 or 2 years. Then she got weaned off those medications, which she was taking for diabetes. and now she's living a healthy lifestyle. So I would advise everybody, every child, because I see a lot of children and a lot of daughters and sons accompanying their mothers here. So I would like to advise you to do something on from your part. You have to start something. You have to feel responsible for your parents, because it's the right time. If any of your parents, not only your moms, if your fathers also, they are suffering from any medical conditions, it is your responsibility to take up a stand that you're going to help them overcome this condition. Okay, whatever condition they're having. So again, thanking Dr. Mani Pavitra for starting this initiative and congratulating her for making this event a grand success. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. That's such an important thing that he said, you know. You wake up at 9, 10 o'clock and you tell your mother, go for a walk. Please don't do that. We're not here to lecture mothers to go, to add little more load on them. If you can do something, you take action. You do something for her so that she has the time to go and work out. That is what we're trying to do. Don't go and give bhashan to people. It is not going to help. Take action yourself so that it will motivate her to take action. That was a wonderful thing. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Noor. Dr. Nasi, your turn. The man behind the show. Today I wouldn't be standing here if he wasn't there. He called me at the night at 10:30. Next day, as soon as he woke up, he met with me. And the next day, he made sure his boss gives me appointment in spite of his super hectic schedule. Come over, Dr. Nasi. This initiative is happening here only because of you. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. The biggest problem with we guys is that we don't listen to our wives and children. That is the most important thing. I mean, after watching you, after such hard work, what you've put on, I take a pledge that I'll definitely listen to my wife and my kid, because they have been not heard properly. The main reason being is I'm being a doctor, I'm not able to give them proper time. But with such an energy, I personally feel that they have to be given more time and they have to be heard. They have not been heard, and I'll make sure that I'll fulfill their promises. Thank you.
Such a valid point, Dr. Nasi made. If my voice wouldn't have been heard at my home, my husband, where is he? Is he here anywhere? Pradeep, there are no words to describe the kind of guy he is. He's all ears. He's always available for me. Anything I want to do, he's just next to me. He doesn't say no. He doesn't know what is saying no to me. Before, right from my childhood, I was a very hardworking student, okay? But I always used to come third, second. But the moment I married him, I got gold medal. I'm the university topper only because of him. So what is the difference between the way I was brought up and him? They used to say a lot of no's to me. No one was there to hear me. But my husband was all ears. He, all my energy, whatever you see, whatever I'm standing before you, it's only because of him. Because he respects me, every word I just say, he reveres me. And I feel like I can do so much. I can do anything. So it's only because of him that I'm here. And Dr. Nasi, that's a very, very wise decision. I'm sure there would be more Pavitras out there if husbands would be listening to their wives. And I would like to call my mom on stage. Today, all the cloth bags that you have, all the vegetable bags, she's distributed more than 2,000 bags across the city. She goes to government colleges every week just to distribute these bags. So I would like her to share her experience.
I'm Dr. Sita. Actually, I was suffering with dysprolapse, cervical, lumbar, knee pain. I stopped practicing. I'm almost to the bed. Then my daughter, she made me, she learned the yoga, she became a yoga teacher, she made me to walk. Now I'm doing 1.5 hour yoga regularly. Now I am 60 years, but now I feel 16 years, mentally, physically, and I'm very proud of my daughter Pavitra, Amlu.
Thank you so much. You know, when I started working out, first I changed. The next person I attacked is my mom. No, I and make sure she moves. You know, she never used to move. She used to always keep complaining. I'm like, why does she do that? How can I help her? It took me more than 8 months to get her just out into the pool. Every day I used to pull her. You know, why I do water yoga in the city? It's only because of her. If she wasn't there, I wouldn't have learned water yoga, because I used to teach her yoga, she used to complain. I used to ask her to go for a walk, she used to complain. Then I thought, okay, what will make my mom happy? And then I discovered water yoga. She used to come in water and enjoy. She never used to do exercise. She'll disturb the whole class. She'll never do exercise. But now, on her own, she goes to a yoga teacher every single day. Not only she goes, she takes my dad along. That is the impact that we can create. It starts from our own home. You don't have to do big things. And after my mother, then her friends came. My Pedamma came. All my family members, my Pedatta is also here. All of them started coming to me. And all of them, we started seeing results. And then their friends and their daughters. And now all of you. That's how. Thank you so much, guys, for all your time. Thank you, Madhavi Garu, for taking time out of your busy schedule. Amit Shah was here. She was jam-packed with work. In spite of that, she took time out just to be here to hear what you guys are saying so that she can take this to the national level. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Ramnath sir, for being here. And Prema Malini, what would I do without you? What am I without you? Every thought of mine becomes a reality because of her. I tell her things and she gets the creative out like that. And that is what is spreading the word. Please give a big round of applause to Prema Malini Varam.
What can I say? You've seen, no? That's it. Visuals speak more than words. So this is the amount of love I have for Manipa Mitra, because she's working for the cause of mothers. And there's nothing bigger and more powerful than a mom. So I felt that I should live up to this and be associated with this lifetime. Forever and ever and ever. That's it. It's a lifetime promise.
I don't want to work on this for my lifetime. By 2020, I want to get 1 million mothers up and running. That's it. Only 2020. 1 lakh mothers, we'll do 10 lakh mothers, they'll take care of the world. That's it, we'll go on to some other past there. Okay, 2020, 10 lakh mothers. Are you guys with me in this? Is it possible? Do you think we can reach out to 10 lakh mothers by 2020?
Yeah.
Yes? Thank you so much, guys. They are still not ready with the results, so what we'll do is we'll go home and announce on social media. And I forgot about one small, little, tiny student who is playing a big, 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 big role. Who is that? Anisha! Where are you? Oh my God, I don't know where I found this girl. I seriously don't know where I found her. 15 cars she motivated. 15 cars for today's event. Give her a big round of applause, guys. Ranak sir, you should give her a memento. And she coordinates all day-to-day activities of 21 Days Challenge. She coordinates with all the doctors. She coordinates all the videos. She takes all the testimonials. I don't know what else she does. And she's still studying. She's still studying in college. Along with her studies, she's doing all this for Million Moms. So you don't need to have free time. You just need to have the right intent. Intent is the word I want you guys to walk back with. Your intent is very, very powerful. Work on it, act on it. Thank you so much, Aniksha. You want to say something, Aniksha?
Million Moms. It was, I was not doing anything for a year basically, and then Premani auntie was always there to support me, and then she told me, come on, Pavitra auntie was there, we had few things going on at home, and then Pavitra auntie came into action, and she's like, come work with me, and since that day, I have always been working with her, and it motivates me so much. She's a person I love and adore a lot, and what
she does, it's so motivating, it's so helpful, and I will continue working with her even if I leave from here. So thanks to you.
So much, Anisha, thank you.
Yeah, mothers are also talented, right? We are talented, we can sing, we can dance, we can do so many things. So I request any of the moms over here to please come over the dais and sing the song, because we have just got 5 minutes to announce the results. So before that, let us have some entertainment. What do you say? Yes? Anything. It can be a song, it can be poetry, it could be an anecdote, it can be a story. Yes? Yes, moms, I know you're all tired, but the results are just 5 minutes away. Just 5 minutes away, yeah? Yes. Can anybody come? Who is coming? Okay. I want my friend Sangeeta, who is here, who is the mom of Aniksha, to please come over the dais, because she's also very important. She's been a driving force to Aniksha. She's been pushing her. I mean, of course, she herself is very motivated, self-motivated, but Sangeeta has always been telling that, you know, this girl is just with you. I'm attaching it to Million Moms. She's going to do all the work. So I request Sangeeta to please come on to the dais. Please give a big hand to this mom. By the way, she also participated in the rally.
Whatever Aniksha is today, it's only because of Prema. She initiates her for everything and she helps her. Thank you so much, Prema and Dr. Pavitra, for everything.
And the winner of the plank challenge, she did a plank for 3 minutes, is Kavita Gullecha. Guys, give her a big round of applause. How many of you can do a plank for 3 minutes? 30 seconds we can't stay, man. Oh my God, that's amazing. Awesome.
Any more? The gifts? The awards? 1 second.
So, Mani Pavitra managed to give us weighing machines. Now, that's a big conspiracy. She is not letting us stay in peace. By the next time we come for the rally, I think she's going to chase us if we are not fit. Amazing gift.
I have something to add to this, Manjulappa. She gave the weighing machine to see that you don't break it. Which means you should maintain your weight.
Absolutely, absolutely. So I am, like I said, out of sight is out of mind. So now we are going to have it right there. Yes. Perhaps in your next to the bed. So whenever we wake up in the morning, we can see. Thank you, very thoughtful actually.
Thank you.
Yet, she participated in the challenge. In today's drive. You want to see her? Mom, come over. We don't come out normally. Imagine she's pregnant, yet she wanted to be part of this rally today. Thank you so much for coming.
What motivated you to be here?
There's my cousin there, Madhuri. She actually motivated me. She's the person actually, she has been motivating me to reduce my weight as well, because I'm on the obese side. But all of a sudden this news came. And when she told me that she is participating, I asked her, are you ready to take it with my morning sickness? She's like, let's go, let's see what's happening. So this is for Lena and Madhuri. Thank you guys.
And for your baby that's yet to born.
And you know, there's only one person who had done it, and that is Payal Valera. Please come over. She posted a video with her doing her exercise, and that's how she motivated people. Awesome. Thank you, Payal. And now comes the best prize, and I'm so happy to announce the winner. Any guesses? Any guesses? So one doubt. I have one.
Good evening. Sorry for the delay. For the results, we had about 55 results to do, so we took about 30 minutes more. We have the provisional results here, so we'll be putting them somewhere and you can check, and there'll be a 30 minutes protest time, and after there'll be a 30 minute protest time, and after that this results will be final. So we're putting this up here.
So as of now, okay, the team which has come first is competition number 20, Rashmi Abhichandani. The team at number 2 position is competition number 56, GVS Naresh. Team number 3, we just... At the third position is competition number 47, Akhilesh. Team number 1 is at number 4 position, Venkateshwari T. At number 5 position is competition number 4, Bama Shivkumar.
Kolli Madhavi Garu, the official BJP spokesperson, is now taking leave. Let's give her a big round of applause and thank you for coming over. Thank you. Ronak sir, you want to share a few words?
I wouldn't know what to say. I'm quite delighted to be here. It was a bit of a surprise. I came to meet Manisha and I thought I'd run into Sarab. But I ran into Manisha and I ended up flagging off a part of the rally, and very delighted to be part of the scheme, and I can see many possibilities here, and I haven't thought of all of them, and I have a few ideas. I think we can sit and work this out, and I suppose whatever I can, even I can support this, because I think we all live in town and I have a lot of space there. In fact, I have enough space for a whole rally out there. You know, I told you about this one, so I made it a plot. So we have 8 kilometers of track within my own house in Jubilees, so we can do a lot of that, and there are a lot of other ideas. I was working out with a girl called Sana, and she passed away, unfortunately. She's a woman who had done some 40,000 kilometers on a motorcycle all over India. All over India and part of Nepal and some other countries, you know, Sikkim and all that. So we had certain plans. Maybe I can take them up with you all. It also involved, you know, all these boys who are stunt drivers, and they have exceptional skills. Only thing is, it's illegal to do that on the main roads, and it's dangerous for themselves and others. So we'd like to kind of promote that kind of activity with the proper safeguards and all that. Yeah, so I think we can work on that.
Definitely, sir. Thank you so much for your support.